Hello, everyone. My name is Val, and welcome to the Grinteq MIC, a podcast series around e-commerce and tech in particular. We have invited a special guest, present among 30 under 30 in 2018 Forbes Italia rating, Joshua Priore, founder and CEO of Worldz. Worldz is an Italian startup launched in 2015, offering e-commerce software products capable of integrating the functions of social networks within the digital shops. Joshua, hi.
Hi, Valeria. Very nice to meet you. Thank you so much for having me.
Very nice to meet you too. And thank you for joining our podcast today. A little bit of the obvious. We saw and felt a massive surge in e-commerce and social commerce in particular between 2020 and 2021, which resulted in paradigm shift. Digital commerce saves buyers a considerable amount of time and effort, and sometimes even money. Then in-store shopping gradually bounced back. However, social commerce continued to thrive. So talking about the trend of social commerce, why do people like purchasing through social media?
Okay, well, this is a very great question, I would say, because, well, people don't like to buy products on social media.
Okay.
This is the truth. In particular, we only 4% of the one who discover products on social media are willing to buy them directly on the social media. Only 4% of them. This is a big problem. You can understand from Meta, TikTok, and all the social commerce platform. I would say social commerce platform, even if they are not social commerce platform. And this is because even with their investment to create social commerce platform to transform their social networks into a social commerce platform, people still don't prefer, you know, they prefer to buy products on e-commerce. And this is normal. An example, let's think about the fact that, you know, you are a user and you find you are finding a new product on TikTok. Okay, so you are seeing just scrolling the TikTok, your TikTok home and your feed, and you see this media content from a content creator and you say, oh, this is a great product. So now you want to buy it. But before to buy it, you would like to know details of the product, you know, the description of the product itself, or you want to know the policy of return or the days of shipment, some external reviews about the product. Everybody knows that now, you know, when you see a sponsored content, it's not that fair, you know, as you can see the product. You want to see other experience. Other user experience. So and you can get all this information just on that social media. You need to find out this information, discover, for example, the e-commerce itself. You don't want to leave your credit card at the moment on social media. If you remember Facebook with Cambridge Analytica, everybody knows that, you know, they collect your data. Me as a user, I don't want to leave my information there. And this means that as a user, I prefer to have a customer experience that is split in two. So the first part, phase, I would say, I want to see the product. I say, okay, I'm engaged with that. I think that I want to buy it, but then I want to buy the product directly on e-commerce, in which I can find, you know, all the information that I need to buy the product. So people are used to buy stuff on social media. Not at all, I would say, only 4% of them, but the kind of stuff can change if social media find out a way to fix all this issue about the experience of the customer.
I see. Thank you so much. And how would we address the following? That even though there is not a large percentage of people actually using social commerce and actually buying goods via social commerce, every day the number of users is growing and there is a widely known adoption by younger generations. And how is it connected with the social media platforms? Which of the platforms would be most popular nowadays? And, you know, how would that impact the adoption of social commerce?
This is a great question, because even if we are not speaking about Meta or other platform as a social commerce, we need anyway to see them as shop windows, you know, of products. We are speaking about the fact that something like up to 4 hours a day people are spending on social media. So there are a lot of brands and shoppers that are trying to reach out to people directly there. So even if Facebook, Instagram, TikTok are not the kind of social commerce platform we are used to think about, they are still, and there are, of course, also shop windows of products. At the moment, we can say that Meta, with the Facebook and Instagram, is still the platform that is preferred by users. But as I told you, we need to see them not as a social commerce, but social network with the opportunity to see and discover products. The kind of good online that I can sell or I can buy is not about the kind of product. It's not about the categories, but it's about the content that you see about that product. Because you are engaged, yes, of course, with the products, but more about the content that is behind the product that you are seeing. Right? And this is something that social media really knows how to do. So, in fact, I will say that during the last month, TikTok has reached globally the market. So now you can see a lot of media content from content creators that show you, you know, the most interesting, let's say, products that you can buy on Amazon, let's say. For example, I remember this bottle that is, you know, it's a flat bottle that you can add to your to your bag as a woman. You know, you can be interested about the kind of products that are very, I would say, unusable, but at the same time, they are more tricky and pretty. Because, for example, I remember the slimes that are very popular here in Italy. They are these strange products that you can touch, and they are for ASMR, something like that, for children. It's, again, it's not about the kind of product or categories. It's about the content that is behind it. If I can, you know, suggest to brands or retailers, you can sell whatever it is, the product that you are selling on social media, using social media as a shop window, of course. But at the same time, you have to be sure that you are engaging the right customers, the right target with the right content. This is the strategy that you have to do.
So it sounds like you have to complement one with the other one. So like take the best from social commerce and integrate it with the e-commerce. Okay, thank you. And what would you say is the impact of social commerce today? Maybe we could run some sort of a short list of its pros and cons, like in a bit more detail. You've already mentioned a couple of them.
Yeah, for sure. Well, if we want to explain, you know, if we want to answer to this question, it is important to clarify that, a little bit of history, let's say that, you know, the e-commerce industry has born before the social media, historically. But we have seen that social media have reached million or billion of people way before e-commerce. And this is normal because it's easier, you know, to convince people to interact each other on a free platform than convince the same people to buy stuff online. If you are thinking about the beginning of e-commerce, when it was not common, you know, to buy stuff online, you were the person that have always bought something, you know, products, whatever it is that you can see, you can feel, you can touch, you can speak with someone to buy them. So this was a very revolution, and it was a long period in which you had to understand how to do it. Now social media, we can say that they can not only influence people on what they buy, but they are trying also to become, you know, platform where people can, of course, interact with each other, but also buy stuff. And this is the kind of thing that they are trying to do. At the moment, it seems that social commerce, if we are speaking about the fact that social commerce is the platform in which you can buy products and you can interact also with people, it seems just to be a trend. It's not something that is, you know, a market that is emerging. Anyway, if we want to say that there are, you know, some pro or some contra about that, we can say in the pro, for example, that there is a huge opportunity to merchants to reach out million or billion of people because they spend a lot of time on that social media platform, and they have to find out a way to interact with them. Another opportunity is the fact that user can discover new products or new brands that are related to their behavior. When I say behavior, I mean the fact that even if social network at the moment don't know how to collect information outside their platform, cookie policy and the GDPR, all this stuff, Meta is closing, you know, the third party cookie as well as Google, as well as Apple. Even if this is happening, at the same time, you can understand that they know what is the behavior of the user while it is or she is interacting on the platform. So they can try to understand what is the behavior also for purchasing something on their behavior. From the other side, I would say that social media have been increased their cost of advertising because of the third-party cookie that is stuck. Anyone can find out this third-party cookie anyway. I would say this is a problem for merchants, for e-commerce, because they cannot find out a way to reach out the target with the cost that they had before. This is a big problem because we are speaking about online shop and advertising. Everything has to be measurable. You know what I mean? So since you cannot reach out your target in a better way with the right cost, you have a problem because you are in the position that you have to manage the brand and the campaign. So this is a problem. And the other problem is the fact that people can be influenced also to buy products that they don't need. Just because you see a content that is engaging for you, but they are selling is something that you don't need. But since they are very good, you know, to let you see that their product, you know, is funny or something that you need, this is a problem. So I will say this is the short list of the pro and contra that I can see.
I just immediately started thinking about all the things I bought, you know, when I wasn't going to buy them.
Yeah, women are willing to pay more than the men, I would say.
I can't say I regret, but still it's quite noticeable. So to sum it all up, so there is functionality behind the experiences presented in social commerce that could be used in e-commerce. So how can we win more customers using these social media experiences in digital stores? Is it possible at all? And what could we do today to not to lag behind tomorrow?
Yeah, well, I would say this is my field. So it is hard to me to summarize all the things that an e-commerce should use or what kind of stuff they have to do. If I could start, the first step is to optimize the customer experience of my e-commerce. So the first thing that I will do is to have an e-commerce that works very well. Without it, it could happen that if I have a lot of budget into the marketing activities, if I don't have a very great e-commerce, you know, optimized, then I can spend a lot of budget and you know, burn it. So the first thing to do is, if I could suggest, is to use customer optimization tools on e-commerce. So they can help to better understand what are the criticisms that you have to solve on the platform. Even if you think that you don't have it, everyone has it. I would also use A/B test because, you know, in online and digital, you can always test two configuration of the platform or the color or whatever it is to see what is the more engaging and just to increase the conversion rate. Well, I think that is necessary for every commerce to have a social network strategy once that I have set up, you know, all the stuff on e-commerce. As I said before, every month, billion of people spend time on social networks, so it is necessary to have a strategy on social network. I guess that it is necessary to cover the entire cycle of the customer experience for the users. For example, you are running your campaign on social, you are taking traffic from the social network to your e-commerce. This is the kind of stuff that you are using to do. Yeah. The first thing is that you want them to buy your stuff. And so you need not only to give them the kind of products that they're searching or looking for, but you have to give them the best service. Because at the same time, I can buy the same product from, I don't know, hundreds of e-commerce. So it's not something just related to the price. It's related to the service that you are giving me because I have to choose you. And this is something that happened not only for retailers, but also for brands, because I can buy on Zalando the same product that I can buy from a brand that sells on Zalando. So I need to have, you know, the kind of experience that I am expecting to have on that e-commerce platform. And the right service to me should be the service that, you know, is something that is related one by one when I'm visiting the platform. In our case, the company that I founded in 2015, Worldz, give you exactly this kind of solution that helps user to have a personalized experience on e-commerce and in the same time bring back also the people to do something online again on social media once that they have been in your e-commerce and they have bought something on your e-commerce. In fact, just to go deeper on that, basically our solution allows user to pay part of the purchase that I'm doing on that e-commerce with a social post. So basically, you can just share what you are going to buy, and once that you have done it, we can give you a credit that is related to the engagement that you have on that social media. I don't know if you had ever seen a Black Mirror, the
yes.
Netflix. Oh, okay. Perfect.
Yes, it actually resonated with me. One of the episodes.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Nose dive, I guess it calls. We are born before that episode, I can tell you. But yeah, this is the kind of stuff that we do. We are trying to bring as could be a democracy of influencer marketing, because not only influencers can have discounts or can buy stuff for free. Even if you are, let's say, a normal user, well, even if you are that normal, you can reach out people, you can engage your friends, your family, your followers, just because you are sharing something. So bring back to the tools, I will use this kind of tool that can help you to cover the full cycle of sales. So if I'm coming from an advertising and then I come inside your e-commerce, and then I see that you are just giving me a personalized experience in which I can have my own personalized price for what I'm buying, just because if I share what I'm going to buy, then I'm covering the full cycle. At the same time, once that I share something, also my friends can see that I bought something. And then in that way, the cycle will restart back from the beginning. So this is something that I will always say to my clients as well. So have an optimized e-commerce with the conversion rate, with the customer experience, use your budget, and of course, engage your customers with a personalized experience based on the social media.
And any views regarding the future, any trends we could see in 2023 regarding social commerce?
We have seen that Meta have been focused during the last year into the metaverse. And this has been more a distraction for Meta than other things. I think that we will see that they will try to win the battle for the engagement of the user on their platform. At the moment, it seems that TikTok is winning. In fact, a lot of people and the Gen Z are on TikTok. It seems that Instagram is losing his battle.
They say, they call it the death of Instagram.
Exactly. The death of Instagram. Just because, the kind of content that you can share on Instagram are the content that is more natural to share. It's not something that is, as Instagram that has to be very precise. Everything has been, with a filter, something like that. Gen Z doesn't like it. Gen Z like natural stuff, something like that. So it seems that, the language of the Gen Z is something that is related to TikTok. So I think that during 2023, Meta will start back from the social network and will be again focused on the fact that they will start back doing feature for Gen Z and feature for the social network itself and not for other things. From the other side, I guess that TikTok has to replicate what Facebook have done in past with the APA, just to give the opportunity to advertising to join their platform better with more features, the way to improve the campaign on their platform. So just to step back, the run to the social commerce, I guess that will be owned by the company that will be 100% focused on social commerce. I don't think that it will be something that is related to social network, because social network are not native social commerce platform. So it is very hard for a social network to turn completely into a social commerce.
All right. So I've got one more question for you. The last but not least, not a tricky one, just a little bit of fun. Ready? Perfect. You have to answer very quickly. Okay. Nike or Adidas?
Oh, well, great question. I guess Nike. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, why?
In Grinteq, we were split into two. Half of us prefers Adidas and half of us prefers Nike. So we're all equal. Why for you? Yeah.
Why for me? Oh my God, I don't know. Well, I was just thinking about the fact that I how many shoes Nike and how many shoes Adidas I have. So I started thinking about that. I said, okay, I think that I have more Nike. So Nike, this is the answer. Yeah.
This is fabulous, Joshua. Thank you so very much. Really enjoyed our conversation today, and it was very informative. And looking forward to see you again soon.
Yeah, please. Thank you so much again for inviting me. It was very a great pleasure for me to join the conversation.